This is Leela James, and you're checking out realmusic.com. Hey. Oh, I've been working on the record, touring, working on my new talk show, My Black is Beautiful, and, you know, just trying to keep it in.
Yeah?
Keep it going.
Okay. For some of the fans on our site, they're new and they're really picking up on a lot of artists. Let's go over your background briefly. How'd you get into music?
I got into music basically through word of mouth, and I put my own band together when I was in college, and I just started performing that way around the LA scene and all the clubs wherever I could, and you know, just develop a following that way, underground following. And then my my demo and my CD just landed into somebody's hands, and then they passed on, and finally I kind of just got a little break.
Okay. Would you who would you say are some of your influences?
You know, definitely old school artists. I like the Al Greens, the Shirley Caesars, and the Mavises, the Arethas, and Marvin Gaye's. I'm into those kind of things, those artists.
Okay. Okay. So, personally, how would you describe your sound?
I would say it was a mixture of old and new, because it's definitely a throwback sound in terms of vocally. I'm gonna give you like real rhythm and blues sound, because I come from a gospel and blues black background, so it's gonna be definitely some real singing going on. Then the music is more updated, so that's the newness, you know. Got a combination of some hip hop mixed with R&B beats, so that's kind of what's going on today.
Okay, let's talk about the soul.
Yeah.
What different did you do on this album than the last one?
Well, I would definitely say the difference between this album and the last album is that I was able to show more sides of me and incorporate more of my hip-hop influence that I didn't put on the first album. And it wasn't that I didn't want to, it was just the way things went in terms of the tug-of-war with the label and what they felt the quote-unquote soul music should sound like, you know. But it's all soul to me, and so with this record, that's what I wanted to show, like, that soul, and, you know, swing can be soul, jazz, funk, blues, it's all soul if you a soul singer, because if you got soul, you can sing over any kind of record. You can give me a country track, and I'm going to make that sound soulful. Make me sing Ave Maria, by the time I finish with that, I'm going to sing that soulful, too.
All right. You got any features on the album that we should look out for?
Yeah, I did a duet with Raheem Zavon. He's on the album. And I'm really excited about that. That was a duet. We had a good time recording it. So, you know, hopefully that'll be the second single.
Nice. Let's talk about the first single, Tell Me You Love Me. Mm-hmm. What was your thought process behind that?
Well, Tell Me You Love Me was produced by Andrea Martin and Gerard. And the thought process basically was to give a record to the streets that had a sample in it, but that we could also mix with, like, kind of a classic R&B feel to it, and say something that was like old school in within content, like, you know, because people don't necessarily talk about that side. You know, we always, as female artists, sometimes talk about, oh, you no good, you this and the other, but we want to kind of say certain things, but not in such a dogmatic way.
Any other tracks you think we should look out for on the album, besides all of them?
Yeah, like all of them.
Cool. Let's talk about your live performance. How do you prepare for a show?
You know what? I don't take myself too serious at all, like, with anything. It's just like when I go into the studio, I don't write, if you will. I just go in, try to vibe out. And when I do my shows, it's the same thing. It's very loose and fun and raw. So a lot of times, whatever happens in the show, most of the time it's happening at that time. We don't really rehearse nothing. So I just prepare that way, just pray and then let it go, and whatever comes.
Okay. How would you, if someone asked you, what's one of your shows like, how would you describe the experience?
Energy. Yeah. Just crazy and just fun and funk and soul. It's just raw.
Okay. any plans for a tour coming up after the release?
Yeah, I'm on the road right now, and I'll be going overseas, doing some dates here as well, but definitely... hitting Europe and Japan again, and I got some couple dates actually right here in New York, I think in August. So, yeah.
Random question: if you weren't singing today, what would you like to be doing?
I probably would have been an attorney. I started law school, so I probably would have been putting somebody someplace they didn't want to be.
And where can people find you online and hear more of your music?
www.leelajames.com. Catch me, Twitter me, Leela James. Facebook me, Leela James. And MySpace, all of that. I'm all over the internet. You Google me.
And the album drop date?
Album drops May 25th.
Sweet.
Yay.
Your music?
Yeah.
James?
Yeah. Yay. I'm ashamed to say how much I want you to say.